Gentlemen, you're most welcome to Abby Talks again. In today's video, we're going to look at how we can deal with the spelling and grammar in Microsoft Word. So to start with, first open Microsoft Word. I open a blank document. So this is my interface for Microsoft Word 2019. So we're going to talk about spelling and grammar, and then we shall talk about tethlers, and finally we shall look about the word count. So spelling is something very important because this one enables as to check for errors or to come up with the correct ones after you have typed your documents. So we're going to have a sample paragraph, and then from there we shall see how we can correct the spelling and grammar. So I will put some paragraph that contain errors, and then I will use the spelling tool to correct such errors. So I'm saying James goes school every day, and this makes him a better student. So when you look at this sentence, I'm trying to increase the size. I'm trying to increase the size, and then so you can see it well. So that is the sentence. I also try to zoom. When you look at this, the sentence says James goes to school every day, and this makes him a better student. So when you look at this, I have around three areas. I have this one, I have this, I have three areas where I have a problem of spelling. So this one here means James goes to school. But when you look at the word I've used, it is having a problem of the word of the grammar, and even the spelling itself is not okay. Every day is not supposed to be like that. And then better is not supposed to be like that. So when you have such a scenario, what you're going to do, you go to your Microsoft Word ribbon of tabs, then from the ribbon of tabs you select the option which says review. Once you click on the review, you get different tools that you can use, and one of the tool is the proofing. Proofing is a group of tools which contains around four main tools. One, you have editor, we have spelling and grammar, we have tethlers, and the word count. And today we say we're going to look at this main three: the spelling and grammar, the tethlers, and then the word count. So let's start with the spelling. The spelling will help me to remove all the errors in my sentence or in my paragraph, and then give me the right words. So I'll go ahead and click on spelling and grammar. So when you click on that, you get another layout that will go on your right side of your interface, and then this layout, it will have the paragraph. As you can see, on that side we have the paragraph. So, and then after that paragraph, you will see down here they have given you different suggestions. Like when you go to goals, right now the highlighted option is the goals. So meaning that Microsoft Word already highlighted for me a word which contains some issues, which has problem that I have to solve. So, and that word is goals. And then they've given me the solution. Like instead of goals, I can select goals, which is down. So I can go ahead and select this one, And then from there, you see now everything becomes okay. And the second thing is a day. So James goes to school every day. So I have to take that solution, that option. And then even here on beta, I still have a problem. That's why it's highlighted. And then I have another solution or another suggestion here. So that one's done. Then I go to every has also a spelling problem, and it has been highlighted in red. Anything which is highlighted in red on the other side is trying to show you that there's a problem, and then they also give you a suggestion. So you can click on that, and then from there, we have the collection spelling is okay. Now we go to the grammar. I'm done with the spelling, everything is okay. What about the grammar? When I come to the grammar, now I have one problem, which is James goes to school every day, and this makes him a better student. So grammar-wise, it means that after every day, I'm supposed to put a comma, meaning that you pause a bit and then you continue. So I have the suggestion, I'm supposed to put a comma there. And then I have another option, another suggestion for student. At the end of the student, you're supposed to put a full stop. You're supposed to put a full stop. So my suggestion is that I've put a full stop, and then everything is sorted. You can see everything has been sorted. The spelling and grammar is now okay. And then even here, I will get a dialog box window that will pop up on the screen, which is telling me that, hey, you know what? You have finished reviewing your editor suggestions. Then go ahead and say okay, and then from there, everything is now perfect. So, as you can now see, I have finished each and everything. The paragraph now has some meaning, like James goes to school every day, and this makes him a better student. So, after looking at this, that is what we call the spelling and grammar. We've seen how to change, how to correct spelling problem, how to correct the grammar issues using Microsoft Word Editor. Now, the other thing we are going to talk is about thesaurus. Thesaurus is a tool in Microsoft Word which gives you the chance to look for other words which means the same. For example, I can say James goes to school every day. Now, if I want to get another word which to mean goes, I have to put the cursor in front of the word of my target. Then from there, I go and select thesaurus. So when I select thesaurus, I will get on my right side, you see thesaurus, and you have a list of names, a lot of names, which means the same thing. So I have goes, then I have different names like lives, travels, works. So you can use any of this one. Like if I select that, then I can select any word like here. Works. So I can also select another word, James labels, James controls. So any of this can apply. Whenever you see a list of options, then you can choose one to mean that, and then you can go ahead and press it. But if I select school and I want to change that, go ahead and put the cursor in front of the word school, and then from there go to the ribbon of tabs in the review tab. Select proofing, and then click on thesaurus. Now the school, the word school will highlight, and then you see different option or different other option that means school. Like we have university, we have colleges, we have seminary. We have institute, faculty, department. So you can choose any of this. Like you can go to university, you can select, I mean, university, and then from there, you can go ahead and change. Then if I select every day, When I select that, every day, each day, all day, every single day, so you can use any of that. Then what about makes? If I select that, the makes is brand, types, kind, stellar. So all these are what we call the Teslas. Tesla is like a dictionary, which gives you a suggestion, which gives you the other way you can make your sentence look better. The other words you can use to mean what you're meaning. If you have a certain word in a paragraph, which other word can you use to mean the same? That's how we can use Teslas. So the other thing we are going to talk about is the word count. The word count is a tool in Microsoft Word which helps you to count how many words you have in your document, how many words with characters, how many words without characters, and how many words with, I mean, how many words without with space and without spaces. So like here, what I'm going to do, I am going to you have two ways you can get that. You have your document right now. It is only one page. So for you, what you do, you go ahead and select word count in the proofing group. And then from there, you get a dialog box window that shows you first and for, it gives you the word count statistics. Here, you get things like the number of pages. Then I have page one. The number of words I have 13. Let me count. See 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I repeat, the number of words is 13. If you want to know, you say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Those are the number of words I have in this paragraph. That's why, of course, Microsoft Word count will pick only the words you've typed. Like the one I just wrote here will not be considered. But now what I typed with a keyboard will be considered, and then it will start counting for you. How many words do you have? There are 13 words. So what about these are words with spaces? What about without space? So here, if I try to go back, I want to remove these numbers I've just written. I just press Ctrl Z, remove them. Ctrl Z, remove all of these words. Okay, so I go back and I bring the word count. I have the number of words 13, characters. Number of characters with space, number of characters without space. So when I mean without space, it means that they're counting all the characters without spaces, without considering the space. So you can count like James has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then space becomes 6. Then it goes, G is 7, 8, 9, 10. Then like that, like that. So you have to count how many characters do you have in your document without spaces. Then you can also count how many characters with space. Like if you don't here without space means you have to ignore the space, but now with spaces, you have to also consider the space. And then the other thing is number of paragraph. Right now I have one paragraph because when you start a paragraph and then you end it with a full stop, it means regardless of the number of lines it has taken on your workspace, it is still considered as one paragraph. And then the number of lines, I have 15 lines. So the 15 lines, yes, those are like how many lines are considered to be in this. There are 15 lines. So the other thing is that include text box, footnotes, and address. So that's how we can do that. If you want to get more information about the word count, of course, you go to the other question mark. I said you come here on this question mark. The question mark, when you click on it, it gives you a help on how to get the what? the how to deal with word count. This help is obtained from the Microsoft Support Center. Like they give you a video, you can watch
See the
the
word
video
or
and write
character
on it.
count and more in your document. As you write, Word keeps track of your word count in the status bar. Right-click for more options like character count. Select Word Count to see more details. You can also see the word count for a selection of words. Select the text and choose Review, Word Count.
So you've seen how you can get support from Microsoft. If you want to get more information about the word count and any other thing that you need to know in Microsoft Word. So generally that's how you can check. I said you can get the word count from the proofing. You can also get it down here on your status bar. Like you have the number of pages. I have page one. Then I have the words. Right now there are 13. Like if I add another word, when I add another word, you can see by putting a space, you can see it's already 10 to 14. Like right now I have 14 words. If I continue writing, I say James go to school every day and this makes him a better student. Better student in everything. Thus projecting him to be a valuable person in the community. So I've added other words on my paragraph, and when you come and check down in the word count, it's no longer 13. When you come and click on that, right now I have the number of words are now 26. And now even the number of characters have increased. They are now 117. The number of characters with spaces are 143, paragraph 1 and line 17. And then the pages still are on page 1. So this is how we can deal with what? With spelling and grammar. Spelling and grammar, we've seen how to do with spelling and grammar. When you click right now on spelling and grammar, you see there's not any spelling problem. When you come to Teslas, first of all, you need to, where the Teslas will consider where the cursor is, the front key. When I come and put the cursor in front of the word community, in front of this word community, so if I put the cursor there, like I put the cursor there, then I go to Teslas, it means that the computer, I mean Microsoft Word, will only consider the word after the cursor. So I will click on that, and then you can see that one will highlight automatically. So by selecting that, I click on that, saying there's no any similar word to mean that. But when I select on the person and select that, I have individual, creature, somebody, human being, and you know, all these are different other suggestions for a person. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching this video. Please go ahead and learn how to use these tools, spelling and grammar, Teslas and word count. They are going to help you much as you become an expert in Microsoft Word. Otherwise, we love you so much for being good clients, being good customers, and continue sharing and liking our videos so that we can help a big margin of the people in the community. Otherwise, let's catch up guys in the next video. Remember to subscribe. We love you so much. Bye.